Do not commit an unwholesome action, for that is because you don't like suffering, you want happiness. In that case, this is what we need to do, this Buddha's advice. Since you like happiness, then what you should do is engage in perfect, wholesome action, subdue one's mind. This is teaching Buddha. So, just subdue one's mind. This is teaching Buddha. This is taking care of the mind. Taking care of the mind. You know? This is the way to take you. How to take care of your mind. Your mind. You are alive. That means you are alive. As well as the body. As I mentioned yesterday. Before we recited karma, rabri, mamatang. So all the phenomena, and particular, all the causes of phenomena, particular, your eye, body, possession, family, all the object of anger, attachment, ignorance. Are they? Particularly these things are there's so much attached to, and your eye is so much not the middle level eye, but your wrong eye, false eye, appearing to your hallucinated mind as it is appearing from its own side, real eye. Or then, in reality, you cannot find neither on the body nor on the mind, as when on any aggregate. There are five aggregates, but you can't find none of that I. If altogether is not I, so you can't find this real I anywhere on this aggregate. It's not a real I, and you cannot find the real I on this aggregate. You cannot find the real I if you search, can't find anywhere in the world. You can't find it in your room, you can't find it in your house, back in the West. You can't find your eye on your bed, you can't find your eye under the bed, in your pillow, in your shoes, in your nose, in your ears. Good man. The real I that we've been believing from beginningless rebirth. You know, can't find all this. From beginningless rebirth, when the believing in trusting real I. As I described yesterday, people say, So reality is so important. You come to know what is I. Oh, from by learning Buddhism, that's what I should say. Only by learning Buddhism, you come to know what is I. That I can say. So, by, you see, mind looking at the beginning, five aggregates we have now. By looking at the base to be labeled five aggregates, and then thought, looking at the five aggregates, that thought merely labeled I, merely input I. Because the base to be labeled the aggregates. So what is I? That's all. Slight more than that is wrong. False I. Slight more than that. That's the object to be reputed in the Madhyamika Parsangika view. slight addition than that, then nearly labeled by mind. So, what is I is what is nearly labeled by the mind. That's all, nothing else. So, that's the reality. What is I? It's extremely subtle. So, normally what we believe, real I from there. I mean, that's so many wrong views and when the eye appears, you know that was this. So mirror level eye by the mind. So then next second is when the eye appears to you, the mind. It should appear. Realities should appear as it should appear to you, merely labeled by mind. That's reality. But that's not for us, sentient being. Not even Arya Bodhisattvas, Arhats, appear merely labeled by mind, no. So maybe Buddha, generally speaking. So, to our hallucinant mind, appear back, not merely labeled by the mind. Not merely labeled by mind. Oh, total opposite. You understand? Totally. Till it falls. You see, like same as believing you have $1 billion in your hand. Exactly the same. There's no $1 billion. There's not even $1 in the hand here now. But believing there is, exactly the same. Or you have a tail, you have long tail like kangaroo. Kangaroo or monkey. Or the longest tail too. monkey, the white monkey, I think. I don't know what you call it in English, but monkey, you know, white monkey. White monkey, don't come near to me, some white monkey, long tail. Anyway, believe in tail. All you don't tell, I have long tail. Like that. Or I have a long horn, all you don't have, you know, long horn. 100% believing. Oh, like that. You understand? So, what does? So that is I mentioned already as devotee. That's happened. Why? You have to know why. So the ignorance, root of samsara, the ignorance, relating to I, the ignorance. Holding the I as real, believing the I as real, existing from its own side, existing by itself, truly existent. So in the common language, real. So, oh, that has left a negative imprint on the mind. So the negative imprint, after the mind may label the I, the negative imprint immediately decorate. The real, truly exists, exists from the real, decorate or project on the mirror label the I. On the mirror label the I. You understand? On the mirror label the I. Project. Then it is, only appears to you, it's third time, third second. Oh, real. Real I. Not a middle of mind, really. Oh, what that. Then completely trust, in trust. You understand? Oh, then. Then because that's the basic. Then, say, you know, then, beside that, cherish. Then numberless Buddhas, then numberless Bodhisattvas, ordinary sentient beings, numberless helplings, hunger gods, animals, you know, numberless fish, water on the air, so many different types of beings in the ocean, under the ground, on the ground, in the grass, trees, in the sky. Wow, just anyhow, wow, wow. Then numberless human beings, numberless universe, numberless surahs. Among all that, this I cherish most. Among all that, this I, what appears real one, then cherish. This is most important. The need for this is most important. Happiness for this I, most important. You understand? Ah, you see? So, most important. You know? Happiness for this I, most important than anything else. Then anybody's happiness, and then this I happen, most of them. Also like that. So then, you see, for somebody who disturb, for this I, you know, to get happiness, who disturb. Anyway, then, you see, then kill, cheat. Oh, tell life, all the bad things, you know, all harms, you know. So numberless sentient beings. So, like, if you have power, that if you have power, you kill millions of people. It happened already historically. One person who doesn't practice patience, good heart, no loving kindness, compassion, or then nothing. Oh, who has power, killed millions of people historically. Happened at different times. And you understand? Already happened. So oh, you don't like? Kill. You know. Yeah, millions and millions. You never think of happiness of others. You don't care. You never think. It's like this. The other sentient beings like this. You understand? So then who helps this? Who help this I in order to get happiness? Who help the attached? Then so much grass, so much attached. So the attachment anger. The basic suffering. That's the basis of it. So that's the problem in the world. Now, how much problem there's in the world? You see? Airplanes again destroyed by bombs and things, and then now it's kind of so easy to have a war in the world, to have a third world war. You know, if not careful, then so easy to have a war. So since the motivation this, you understand? Since the motivation, the root, you know, this. You see, hallucinated eye, then complete in trust. Oh, that from that root. Or then, all the rest. Three person mind, six root delusion, 20 second delusion, and the 84,000 delusions. So, three person mind. So, Buddha gave 84,000 teachings opposite that. So, so you see, so with that ignorance wrong, day and night, creating karma with the body, spirit, mind, and others, numberless intimates, the harm. Nowadays, weapons to harm, to develop. Mm-mm. so towards others. Whatever harm you do, put in prison, torture, just anything, what you can do. Amazing. So all come from this wrong concept. You see? Completely interesting, this false I. Can you understand? Everything comes from that. Can you imagine? This wrong concept. Believing the false I is real. You understand? So the samsara came from that. The six realms, you are experiencing six realms suffering. Amazing, amazing. Unbelievable. Came from that. Even the diarrhea came from that. Even diarrhea today. But ticks going through, or whatever, I don't know, but limbs or. So everything comes from that root, that ignorance root, that subjection. Everything, including black magic. Someone do black magic to you. That's because in the past you did black magic to that, to those sentiments in the past. So, see? Do those sentiments, you did black magic in the past. So this time they come back because of that. Not that know that, not because they know that. It's just coming result. That's what they said, the black magic to you. Then you see, then there's karma. You harm others. There's karma. You harm others. Then they become cause to receive harm back to you from others. You create the cause. That becomes, you harm others, become cause to receive harm back to you. That's the result. So you don't know that, but that's what it is. Karma, cause and result. But you don't know. So constantly did you ignorance. You create the cause of suffering. You create the cause to receive harm from others. All the time, day and night also. So that's what live the life. And then they can say happiness. Cause of happiness, small measure, even you have created a small measure, but it's always destroyed by rising anger and heresy, ill will. Destroyed. Or even when the teaching is given, when the teaching is given about karma, people run away. They're afraid, they run away. It makes them sad, they run away. So like that. Even explain the truth, they run away. But if it explains something wrong, they believe in that. Complete trust. If you plan something right, they run away. It's like that. The sentiments. And like that. So sad. So anyway. Mm. Or this write down. Must write down. And remember. It was remember. When something happened to you, when some disturbance you don't like happened to you, make sure, like football. You know, when you get football, so to others, to not take your football, so you have to give to your partner. I mean, partner, what? partner, your what do you call? Your partner? Huh?
Team.
Your team. To go put in the goal. So anyway, so without missing the chance, without delaying, without missing chance, without others taking away. So as quick as possible, remember this. As quick as possible, first thing, remember this. Oh, then anger doesn't lie. No way. Then patience. No anger. So they said, like a lady which might come up persuaded. Therefore, I receive this harm. My karma persuaded to others. In the past, I harmed others first. Oh, then, you see, dala naje dijunde, therefore, I receive this harm. Teve semje nyatona, dala tada malayu. So by that, didn't I make that sentient being? To lose in the hole of the hell. Didn't they make the sentence to lose in the hole of the hell? That's, you see, not just patience, compassion. You use others giving harm to you, you use that to develop compassion. Not instead of harm, get angry and harm, you develop compassion and benefit others. Okay, you understand? Peace. Oh, this, then you can bring peace in the world. Otherwise, peace is just, otherwise, just peace, just words between two lips. No peace. Yeah, peace is just jog. It's just jogging. Then you bring peace, you see? You bring peace to in the family or outside, where you are. Or you're able to do that. Somebody abuses somebody, then you use that to develop compassion. Wow, not just patience, compassion. Wow, bring peace to others. A family outside the office, anyway. Then that means you are bringing peace in the world. Understand? So write down these words, directly. Oh, that's not my karma persuaded. Dala noche de jungte, depo a respis ham. Dale tata nyatona. Teve semje nyatona. Dale tata mala. Therefore, do not make the sentiment to lose in the hole of the hell. So, first, I gave harm, you see, but to abuse, to like that. Then, receive harm this time from others. So, by this, put the clean karma. So, you see, what the harm it does to the sentient being is then they were in human body before. Then to disappear from that human realm, then get reborn in hell. So you caused? You caused. Who's caused? Who met them to Pomona Hill? You caused. You understand? So because abuse charges. You see? Harm. So as a result, they harm to him. So then that next karma, then met them to. They were human being born, human body before. They disappear from that and born. Of course, born in the hell realm, on the whole of the hell. Oh, that's the jewel of compassion. Unbearable compassion. That you're doing this. So there's impossible to get angry. So compassion. So you need to do something, you need to help. At least pray, dedicate your merits. At least that. To not be born in hell realm. To not be born in hell realm. To be free from this nigrama. How you want it? To be free from samsara, to eat and that. You pray. At least. Then whatever help if you can, you help. So at least pray. So this very important. You see others harming you use to develop not the patient, compassion to others. So important, most important practice, most beneficial practice. Right on. Otherwise, you know, it's good learning Buddhism, meditation, learning Buddhism or meditation, whatever meditation, whatever it is, you know, called meditation. I don't know that. Yes, but you never practice. Learn the words, but you never practice. Like investing in the computer, embedding information in them. Learn, no practice. Your mind is the same. Your mind is not development. Very far from Dharma. Your mind and Dharma. Very far. Your heart and down, very far. Your mind is set, very ordinary, undeveloped, full of delusion. So, whenever something undesirable, see, hear, whatever, the anger rises immediately. So, every day, so many times. All of that. So, then negative action of body, killing, stealing, sin, all of that. And body, speech, mind, day and night. So all the time creating cause. You are creating all the time cause to be in samsara, especially in the lower realm. But eons. And then, so then you see, you are always creating cause to receive harm from others. Always. Day and night, all the time you're creating cause. Give harm others, to receive harm from others endlessly, your extreme cause. Oh, that's a reality. So you see, the airplanes, people flying the Russian airplane two times, just into Turkey, before that, in, I don't know which country, Russian airplane bursted, destroyed by bomb. Which country is that? Huh? Egypt, yeah. And so forth in the recent time. Just that, all those, and then In America, that always happens. Many times, young children. I mean, young. I haven't heard girls, boys, young boys, small young boys. But it was allowed to have guns, so shoot many people. It happens again. Then there's a grown-up person. Oh, you see, they thought it's maybe a crazy person. They checked, it was normal, like them, to, you know, going job and, you know, whatever they do, this person also doing the same thing. So they thought, nothing wrong. So the only, he changed it that day. Then he got a gun, killed many people, museum. So this happens at America sometimes. Very, very interesting. Sometimes. So that they have so much problem whether to allow gun, not to allow gun. Well, many years ago, that were months of meeting, but I don't think any solution. So without allowing gun, then how to protect you? We should worry about that. So you see, now you see,
the country, the government, or the wealthy person, even you have a powerful bombs, even you have a hundred thousand atomic bombs, you see, but you develop compassion. But if you develop compassion to others, to sentient beings, you see, so even if you have 100 atomic bombs, it doesn't harm to others, not dangerous to others. If you have compassion to others, that. So if one person has compassion to others, to numberless sentient beings, wow, brings so much peace, happiness, to the sentient beings, at least even sentient beings in this world, doesn't harm. Wow. So take care of them like yourself. Everyone you cherish like yourself. Or even cherish more than yourself. Everyone cherish like your child, like yourself. Everyone. Not only human beings, even creatures, everyone, like yourself, more than yourself. So all those happened. Why it happened? Why? So the Akasan, what's his name? The CN man, the CN important man. Huh? Anderson Cooper. He wanted the man killed and many people at the museum. He wondered, why? He was asking ordinary people in the road. But he knew they cannot answer. But he was interested to ask. You know, he knows that they don't answer. But he asked, why? But he should ask his owners, he should ask the great meditators who have clever ones.
should ask, but they don't ask. There are many people who know. Those who have great knowledge beyond what ordinary people's perception. Beyond. They don't ask. They don't know. They don't ask. Only ordinary people they ask. Interviewed the only ones whom they know. And that the Muslims, they don't Dhamma, they don't know Karma. They don't know about life. They don't know where suffering came from. They don't know from where happiness came from. They have no idea. They only relate to outside. No. So then, yeah. So you see, all those So this is so Andrew, so she and men, Andrew Cooper, or that is those who have omniscience, those who, Buddhas who have omniscience, ask or the. Those who have even not omniscient, sentient being, but having deep clairvoyance. You know, past lifetimes can see 1,000 lifetimes, your 1,000 can see others, 1,000, 10,000, blah, 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 blah. They don't ask them. Don't get to ask them, don't know. So, that, So many of these answers, they don't know what's happened. So anyway, all this, because those people harmed, even those group people harmed to this person who killed him, they harmed in the past to this even one person. Harmed in the past, killed. So, as a result, now, then this person killed them. All that, because it's not pure, the karma is not purified, negative karma is not purified. They don't have karma, they don't have dharma, they don't have karma, they don't have mind, they didn't purify. So, didn't purify. So then they experience karma. And then they get killed by others. So that abuse, killed by others. Similar abuse by others. You are abused by others. First you didn't purify karma. You didn't dharma, you didn't know dharma, didn't know mind, didn't know karma. Oh, didn't believe reincarnation. So you didn't get purified negative karma. So then negative karma happened that you abused him. So this life abused you. So this happened. So what caused the person to abuse you? It's bad. That's yourself in the past. With ignorance, with subjection to harm others, abuse others in the past. Could be billion, zillion, trillion years ago. Even this early life. Life before this. Or even the early life this. So karma can happen. What you created yesterday, result will happen today. What you created this morning, result will happen this afternoon. So all this, whatever happened
trouble, whatever happened in the world, is a result of, is it's all done by you, by themselves in the past, harmed others that way. So now that karma is not purified. So then you see harm for others as a result. So in the Bodhicavatara, Shinjadeva said, Great Bodhisattva, Shinjadeva said in Bodhicavatara, Munje dage semje la dendeva indava che teve semje chejeve dalam no che dejungri. Munje dage semje la, in the past I gave such harm to others. Teve semje chejeve dalam no che dejungri. So therefore, sentient beings giving harm this time, you see. So I'm very worthwhile to receive this harm. I'm deserved to receive this harm. Oh, the Shinjadeva said. You look at life. Oh, I can give harm. Anybody I don't like, I can kill, harm, destroy, whatever. You see? But nobody can harm to me. Is it like that? But nobody, I can give harm to anybody, but nobody cannot give me harm. I mean, nobody should not harm to me. How is that? Nobody should harm to me. I should have always happiness, not others. You, I should have always happiness. Nobody can harm to me. Nobody. Even mosquitoes biting me. Even ticks biting me. But that, nobody can harm me. But you see, if you don't like, you can kill, you can do everything. Others, normally sentient beings. Can you imagine it's like that? Do you accept that? Do you accept that? Can you accept that? Can you accept that? You think? Really, it doesn't matter. That's the whole point. Wrong concept. Can you accept that? To practice? Do you want to live like that? You want to live like that? Anybody, I can kill anybody, but nobody is allowed to harm me. Is it like that? So, you understand? That's how the world in the world, that's how people, if you look at the life, it's how people do. You understand? Most people, except the bodhicitta, bodhisattva, great holy beings, like Kadamba Geshe's work. So they, I think, you know, people who have anger to you, or they practice strong compassion. They practice strong compassion towards the past, towards that sentient being, the holy beings. You understand? There's a verse from Bodhicitta, but or Kadamba Geshe, but I don't remember now. Like that. You understand? The Buddhist, or Buddhist, holy beings in there. That brings happiness, brings so much peace, happiness to the enemy, or to the other who harms you, than yourself, to the world. Wow. The Buddha said, who whom you benefit a lot, whom you benefit a lot, and who you expect to receive, to help you in a term, but that, you see, that person, that sentient being, in return, gave harm to you. Totally wrong, gave harm to you. Then Buddha, what Buddha do? Strongly cherish, I mean strongly cherish, or strongly generate compassion to that sentient being. You understand? Who harm you? Whom you benefit so much, or you expect to only give help, but only give harm. For that's who, in the world, people think, people are just so shocked. But Buddha generates strong compassion to that person, to that sentiment. You understand? Please keep this in mind. It's all like that. What was that? So reason, we see, the reason why His Holiness, to, you know, advise people, young people, Tibetan young people, to not fight to the men in China, to not fight men, to be kind, be peaceful, to not fight back to men in China. Advice to young Tibetan people, but the young Tibetan people won't fight like the rest of the world do, rest of the world. If somebody harms you, you are bad. You know, they won't do that. So, but he's only, don't do that. And you see, to be kind to not harm. So, he's only the advice. Oh, the reason. Old people, not how much they are wise in politics or what, they think it's so silly. His Holiness so silly, they might think. His Holiness is like, they might think His Holiness like child. I don't know that, But, if you harm to others, or men in China or whoever, you're creating cause to receive harm to you from them again. You understand? Again. If you harm, you can cause to receive harm again. Continuously receive harm. Even you harm one time, but result coming evolution. You receive harm endlessly again. Lifelong, endlessly uses harm. Until you purify the karma or until you achieve a higher path where karma they cease. You know? Until you achieve the higher path. So, by harming others, then you see, there's no benefit. You know, you're not benefit. So how you can have realization of that? No way. So that. So you're harming the men in China, and then you see you create the Tibetan people, then creating cause to receive harm from them on, you see, 100,000 million, on endless. Even from one harm. Either you purify or actualize path. You know, that stops experience karma. So that's why His Holiness advice.
people, about peace, peace for mainland China and peace for Tibetan. You understand? Mm. So that. So being kind, not harm, being kind, benefiting others, then it brings happiness to you and others. Mm. In Bodhicaptara, please understand this. In Bodhicaptara, by great Bodhicaptara, chita many madana, sekpa pongwa minishin, techin dangni madana, tunga pongwa minuwe, tete dangni siwata, shenye tunga siwiji, dangni shenla dangwata, shenla dashin suwa cha. So what he's saying is that chita many madana, if you don't drop the fire, there's burning fire in your head, if you don't drop, the burning cannot be stopped. As long as you're keeping the fire in your hand. So people in the world, general people in the world, is those who practice Dharma sincerely, who knows karma, who knows mind, that you think. Otherwise, just people, you know, there is no holding fire, cherishing the eye, cherishing the eye, holding the eye, the false eye cherish. Oh, that is like holding fire. That and doesn't know it. It's burning, but you don't know. It's due to holding fire. You doesn't know that. You don't know that. So you hold with holding the fire so important. The most important thing in life. The holding the eye. Unbelievable. Holding fire. They don't know that it's burning. They don't like the burning. They don't know for what causes that. Would you think it must have Muslim like, oh, that's a so if you don't drop the fire, the burning can never be stopped. So that many matana sabha pomni. Tejintani matana dunga pomni. So like that, if you don't give it the eye, you know, the one you cherish, as you entrust somewhat, or the you cherish somewhat, you know. So this real eye, don't want to give up. If you don't renounce this eye, then the suffering cannot be abandoned. The suffering cannot be abandoned. The undeserved suffering cannot be abandoned. Chita dhani matana dunga panga mniwe. Tete dhani shivada shingi dunga shivi. In order to pacify the suffering of yours, and in order to pacify the suffering of others, therefore, then give up yourself for others. You give up yourself for others, cherish others as yourself. Cherish others as yourself. So reality is the method explained all this. You stop, if you harm, you suffer, others suffer, okay? If you benefit, if you stop suffering, if you stop harming, then if you stop harming, then happiness to you, peace happens to you and others. Same thing, if you benefit others, if you benefit, happiness, peace for you, success for you, success, happiness, peace for others. You understand? That is the key thing to know, to learn after coming in this course. This must know that. So harming brings suffering to you, cause suffering to others. Constantly. So offering benefits then brings success, happiness. All your wishes get fulfilled. All true and all others. Brings happiness to all others. Okay? That's the most important subject to come to know and practice after coming to this course. Lama Sangje, Lama Tse, Deje, Lama Gunje, Jebo, Lama De, Lama Jebo. So again, prayer. we're going to enlist this one. this verse is enlisted. instrumented. After all, talking about emptiness. Just before that, you see, we have one older student who translated Dharma in French, but many years ago. She's a young girl. I don't know how old is in France, but Germany. Old student, translated Dharma. And she was young and, she was young and beautiful and all that. But you see, her body, her hands, and just, I'm not worse like that, but now. But, hands have become like this, and it's all, how do you say? Not deformed. Is it deformed? It's like deformed, he says. So not deformed. There should be meaning like, So whole heart body became changed. So she was, I didn't remember. She said, I didn't do what bad I did in my life. Didn't keep people. So, what did the bad I did? But I become like this. The body totally changed. Become like this. And, shifts, except the face. So, it's totally become different from the young time. So she was, what did I do? What did I do? She was saying, surprised. But you see, she was not thinking, she was thinking of only this life, but only even this life. But you never know what karma you create, even this life. You don't know all the karma. You don't know all the next karma you would create. So, the past lives had no beginning. Continuation of the past life. Continuation of life has no beginning. No beginning. So she said, I think she does think that. Continuation of past has no beginning. Beginningless life. So, unbelievable karma, unbelievable. Heavy karmas, numberless. You could create in the past. The next heavy nikram. So she doesn't. So what is this? What is this? So she was so surprised because her body became more tense. What is it? She was so surprised. There's no, everything has a reason. Every desirable thing you are experiencing has reason. Every happiness, happiness can be good karma. Every suffering has a reason. Every small suffering, every small comfort, even when you feel a little hot, then, wind, cool air passing through, feel comfortable. Even that, comfort, even the dreams, everything is a reason. Everything is a reason to happen. Because pleasure comes from good karma. Small, big. Every small, every great suffering or small suffering, all comes from good karma. Everything can run like that. Now, there's no one experience, happiness, suffering, that you experience or other experience, didn't come from karma, without any reason happening. There's nothing. Then, without dependent cause, it's happening. Without dependent cause, with the cause, the condition happening, then it's That means they're independent, and that means they do not exist. So it becomes that. It becomes a nihil. So anyway, like that. She was saying like this. But of course, you see. But of course, Nuju digbeti wu yongan de, mintu dunga chata babju chang, lenghen de wu sibe juton de, jengan lam dolong wa chinirum. Nuju digbeti wu yongan de, nu is a place, ji is a sentient being, digbeti wu yongan de, fill up, resolve nigrikama, all the problems, so many problems. No rain, no rain, and wash under the destroy the crops, all the so much of the war and the disease of contagious, some fill up the result of the grammar suffering. When they do not have the budget, so undesirable sufferings like and falling, like raining. So much happened to you, like raining, like rainfall. Dunga chata bajuja, even it happened like this, lingen devisibit, use on it. First thing, seeing, experiencing this, receiving all the, you know, all the from the experience, is finishing. Finishing, first this finishing past exam, resolve the suffering. Past exam. Which is the result of the suffering. So, finishing past karma, cause of the suffering, finishing, by experience, finishing. So, you see, you rejoice, enjoy, you see, finishing is good, positive, because all past nikram has been finishing, positive. Then, jenga lamdo longa chinjiro. Very important prayer. So important prayer. Jingan lam to lodge. Asking, requesting to Guru, grant blessings. To be able to utilize bad condition in the path to enlightenment. Bad condition, unfavorable condition, suffering. Utilize in the path, not suffer, worry, woo. In the path to achieve enlightenment, highest, peerless happiness, total cessation of suffering, the obscuration, completion of realization. For sentient, not for you, for sentient, numberless sentient beings, numberless sentient, numberless helpless, hungerless, numberless animals. Above, numberless ants, numberless mosquitoes, numberless makers. Number what ticks and misgoods, what every animal, every human, wow, so utilize your suffering, your cancer, your death, whatever happened, relationship, what you utilize in the path to enlightenment. Wow, to achieve the highest. You understand? Oh, this is Mahayana. This is
benefit of having Metta Mahayana teaching. You understand? Oh, Jingalamdu Lama Chinjalu, Rikrishna Guru. Oh, that's the first thing. Second things. So this, all this suffering came from ignorance, root of samsara, holding the fourth eye, you know, that. And cherishing that eye, most important. So, all this suffering came from that, whatever, dying or relationship problem or whatever, your cancer or curable disease, uncurable disease, whatever. So I use this to benefit for them. So I experience, I take the suffering of all sentient beings, in particular death or whatever relationship, whatever you have to, that. The numberless sentient beings has that. So I take it on me, and I experience. For them, let them to be enlightened, free from suffering, be enlightened. Numberless sentient beings, not only your friends, numberless sentient beings, include your friend in this danger. Numberless sentient beings, let them to be enlightened. Take all your suffering, let them to be enlightened. Then, you see, you take it on your experience for them. All other things, even deeper, destroy. You use as a weapon, like eternal bomb, to destroy your ego, the subject towards ignorance. Destroy from where all the suffering, all the obstacles come. Destroy it. Like eternal bomb. You know that? So my experience of suffering is instead of numberless sentiments suffering, my experience in this be the substitute of all sentiments suffering. My is whatever dead, you're dying, whatever happened, this may be substitute of all sentiments suffering. My experience suffering is to be a substitute of all sentiment suffering. So make it so worthwhile. You experience that so most worthwhile. And then any whatever problem is, make it most useful, fruitful, benefits to you to numberless sentiments. You understand? The master experience suffering be substitute of all sentiments. So let the sentiments to not suffer being that. Then your life becomes most happy. You use your suffering and favorable condition or unhappiness. You use best. See, path to achieve enlightenment, to achieve full enlightenment. And to free the numberless sentiments from oceans of samsara suffering, bring them to enlightenment. All of that.
So unbelievable that your life becomes like diamond, gold, diamond. Like which can jewel like that. Wow, 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 wow. That's the happiest life. You are dying, but you make happiest life. Your relationship, you have sickness, whatever. You have failed in business, whatever. You make the best. You see? Most useful. So then, just a little bit. So a little bit here. I'm not teaching power. not transparent kind, no. So in the death process drone explained to you, I mean you meditated and so that. So in the intermediate stage, so the 25 observations. The absorption four elements and then they get the five aggregates and five wisdom best time five wisdom. Absorb the I don't remember completely. So, 25 hours. So then the five inner science, outer science, vision of white path. Increasing red path. The near element dark path. So during those times, each situation get absorbed. So mind be more subtle. Then after that, the clear light. You know those things have been. The red seed from the receiver mother, from navel shooting up the red vision, the white seed, with the white seed coming down from there, through the channel, the weather condition, the vision of white part of them, white vision there. Then meeting together, the center of the two eyebrows, the indestructible city inside the center artery. So then, to meet the white seat, red meet, and then the negative and dark vision. Then one split, then the clear light. So the so that is the time meditate. Before. So that is the main time, clear light meditation, the recognize clear light, use emptiness, if your realization emptiness, then what the tantra experience is. Yeah, so and that was about the high tantra that they use. So mentioned that. So Lama is has didn't order me, but Damsa Tushita, but told the Pero, Claudio, Stephen, or some students, Lama told them. Maybe Chambachuchi, Spanish nun who wrote Love the Lama, this book. Maybe Jackie Minari, who worked as a secretary for 6-7 years. So anyone, but didn't tell me, they told him that when he passed away, if all the students gathered in one Gomba place, so then he would meditate at the time of death, so mystical night. He would meditate 1 year, he said. When I come back here, old Gomba upstairs, on the Lama's table, there's note. Shanti Deva, during the killer light, passing with killer light, he meditated for 1 year. He was in meditation for 1 year. It was written there. That. So Lama can do that. He achieved in the common view. Me, the ordinary mind view, Lama has achieved the very high tantra, not only three parents, but the generations that completions, the clear light, illicit body, those achieved, even the common view, like that. For reality, of course, enlightened being. So Lama came to that. He meant it. He had planned with it, but passed away in America. We went to America to the abortion. No, not abortion. Operation. Abortion. Abortion. Thousand children jogging. So anyway, to the operation for Lama, asked his own eyes, and his own did observation, said, good to do. So we went to America to operation. So after the house, Lama bought a house, after 6 months of traveling, giving teaching, then go back there for rest, and to mint it was, bought a house near that Abtrus. That's the western way, it's the most beautiful, but dining room in the behind ocean, so it's a kind of better feng shui, better kind of feng shui. Landscaping with house and more that, but it's the worst house, worst. But then Lama, what happened was I don't know this thing, after the house was sold to one old couple. The old couple, the neighbors around the road, the high road, the neighbors, everybody complained. The neighbor, they told me that I met one student waiting, not waiting, So at the marriage wedding, so there's one marriage wedding item. So then this couple came. They explained, oh, the neighbors complained them. Even the near the beach, down below the mountain, the house is here. So down the house, even they complained now. Maybe the garbage coming down, I'm not sure. But so everyone complained, wah, 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 wah. But that didn't happen to during us time. So anyway, then Lama took the aspect of the beside their heart, what people say, doctors say, say. On top of that stroke, Lama took stroke, but Lama asked, it doesn't need, but Lama asked me for me to purify, so to wash, to bless the water, and to do washing to Lama. So I, you know, Taj Lama asked us. But that, not necessarily by my washing, but it just got better. That's the small one. And Lama was in the hospital in the, after, I think maybe after the hospital. Then they were there, went to Los Angeles for operation in a very good hospital. So they opened the new treatment, they opened a hole there and they put something, I'm not sure what. So Lama, when he, nobody allowed to go in, so when Lama came out, he said, I must pass by there, only they put this through a hole there. So then Lama said, well, one day, next morning, then I think, Lama said, we'll go for the John Jackson, John Schultz, and the director of the Bajapani, me and several people, cooked carbon monk to the Malams. So the Lama sent us to a Chinese restaurant, but we went to Mexican restaurants, and I came back. Last letter to Lama was a Geshe Wangchang's letter, card from London, jamming centers, residency for many years, alone, no attendant, alone. You travel by bus, and he's a great Geshe, Jebu Munsi, he's a Lingri, which is a guru, many other lamas. Mm. So he passed away, maybe 6 months, I'm not sure, yeah. He spoke to his son spoke to him, he spoke to his son, then he passed away. That his card was the last letter to Lama. Mm. So I think 3, 4 o'clock, I think the Tibetan New Year Day, the Lama passed away. Mm. So then, so rest the story, doesn't it? There's no time. You know. So the so I invited his own son, which is Lama's guru, my guru. With many in the Saragat and Jemu, there's so many monks, guru, initiation, the teachings. So I invited Rimitsu was Switzerland. So Rimitsu came, I invited Rimitsu before. To cure all the lamas, the stroke thing, what aspect. So Rinpoche did a haikewa, not more sikrawa, the sikra haikewa, different. There's special puja, meant to get rid of this. So Rinpoche did that puja, then left to Switzerland. Then the lama passed away, all invited again back to. So during Lama's after Lama passed away, then the fire puja and all this offering fire to Lama's holy body, all the Rinpoche did. Rinpoche was there and So the Rinpoche did Jangwa, which
of course, also reality, of course, doesn't need to add, you know, it's only for ordinary being. So anyway, he wanted to the Lama's holy body and we did the self-initiation, Heruka body mental and Bajogani, at least 2 days. Then on the top of the Bajapani mountain hill, then Lama's holy body is brought with the deities, Christians, and then all fire. And, so then we were doing puja. Then the ex-monk from Gelugu Monastery down beneath, near Baudas River, says in Losan. So he was, he knew how to keep the body in Tibetan. I mean, the tradition where legs up and this, you know, he knew how to do it. So the, he was helped by some student, John McKay or John Jackson, I think. There's another one, Chuck, this is John Brown. So anyway, helped to, by the three other people to, there was isolate and the holy body to, I think, maybe to not get smell, I'm not sure. It was done in the West normally. So he said, he told Rinpoche, he saw somebody, he was so surprised. When he was taking out the holy body, keeping the holy body was not like dead, solid. It's so soft, like not dead, so soft. He was so surprised, so shocked. So surprised. Oh, you there? In the room on Lama's holy body? No. In the room when picking up Lama's holy body, you were there? No, I don't think so. You were there in the room? No, in the room, not in the Gomba, but the room where Lama's holy body was kept. Keeping it. Lhasa was making the Tibetan way, the Jesus way. You were there? You were there or no? The holy body was packing, or the, being packed up. Huh? During that, I don't think you were there. Huh?
The night before I was there, but I think that was during the day right before that.
Yeah. So, Lojong also so shocked, so surprised. He was so shocked. It means he didn't pass away. Then all he was making the holy body like this. So with the initiation, the crown, the put and all this, so hands like this. So he was making up. So all at that time, then Bodhicitta came out. The, you know, from here. Well, Western, I think it's only down there. Only down there, that when things come from here. I don't know, that's what I heard. But anyway, come out. Then he said, he told me, oh, such a bad smell, he said. He told me when Bodhicitta came out, when it came out, then Kanjin lips. Then that time, that is one definition, Kanjin slept that time. So Lama did have plan that. Of course, all the students to come in one place may not fit, and also all the students won't be able to come. So, so I told Jaswan, but this is what Lama said, and Rinpoche, of course, Lama didn't have a name, great mentor, just expert, learned geshe, and. Very hard for all the combatants. I mean, this is everyone knows, but very humorous all that. But doesn't
people don't know this great mentor or that. You know, exercise, what is said in teaching the exercise, people don't know. They think I'm the mentor. They think told the wrong way. They think told the wrong. I'm the mentor. I'm the better Dharma person. That people, Tibetan people, told the wrong. So, Jebji Swami said, he said, no, cannot be, because only in Tibet, even in Tibet, only his Dalai's gurus, only the holy body is kept. And he said, so I'm not sure what I clearly explained. I'm not sure. I did explain. So Rinpoche, even normally doesn't keep the holy. Only in Tibet, even that he's on the only his own gurus, he said that. So, and then he said, which is the aspect he said that, you know, that he will be criticized by other people. Which he said that. So, because the Lama doesn't have name, the great mentor, this. Even though the Lama is beyond, you know, but it's difficult for people. I was like people to understand what the Lama is. So, you know, Lama is with the old people, or with the Lama is with children, then he played with the children. So, whoever people were better. So, so to when people, Lama's business people, Lama business person, or Lama this. So, this is what they think, but they don't know. Really great mentor who actualized path, no idea. So, so then Rinpoche didn't give us permission. So Rinpoche, you know, it's our custody. Maybe so, I don't know. Maybe you don't have merit. So Jackie Kelly was very upset. The among the students was Jackie Kelly, she knew that Lama said. So she was very upset. She was. So and she did much devotion to Lama. Worked was secretary for 7 years, I think maybe more. So even the Lama's tissue, you know, snort and the speech, she can't throw in the garbage. She Buddha or whoever. Mm. So she dare not throw in the garbage, even the tissue, like that. Much devotion. So anyway, so since when he was picking up the holy body, like his legs up, then only bodies that came out. But before Lama didn't. Lama was a meditation. So if it happened, well, now one house, all the students come to Bajapani, Sabha meditation, then he would live for one, he would meditate for 1 year in the clear light. So now, the Lama's case like that. So we offered a fire. Then when the fire was offered, then Jajja Sonamaji was watching. But the fire is white. Smoke is white. Not fire is white. Not fire is smoke is white. So color of the smoke also describes where the person gets born. So white. And so it's not very happy. It's not a song with story. Or Lama. Lama is Resha. So who actualized Tantra path. Lama is who has actualized Tantra path. So even of course, as I mentioned before, Kerala is completion stage. So a listener said, oh, his face was happy. And like nothing but Jiraisha, you know, who actualized the tongue's part. Well, he's not someone who said that, told me. He was happy when the first smoke came out. So tepje ling rinpoche te sona chalama su guru paswe. I think it was a cloud argumentation for. It didn't it? Kunyong. So what's it? To them, sugar. Oh. Ah. It didn't it in meditation. Clear light. Yeah, long time. Many. I think the, our first student, Zina Nan, she did, Yamata Lama told him, Lama told her, millions mentors. Then she went to the mountains, Jimbesi, to Chichin, which is the monastery. So she did Yamata Bashavibini. She wrote, few pages later, so much experience of Vajrayogini, so much experience, but I couldn't understand all the English at that time. I was building monastery a lot. So she called me, she asked me to come down, but I didn't get to come down. So she had a very good experience. Anyway, so she passed, she had some storm problem, and she passed away, she held the mother, and then her daughter was small here, and then touched her knee, mother, please don't die, her daughter is small. But she was in meditation. So I think she was in meditation, I don't know how many days. So, when she said, she was born in Pure Land, but in Pure Land, Tabakacho. He's one of the teaching which said. So, when her body was brought outside, very good weather, very good, sun, very good day. So, that is also related. Karma. So, then I didn't get to go up there, but I was a Nyima, we have one attendant, Lama's disciple in Tibet. He went to look after Jesus. Oh, then, Thakri Daji Chang, Thakri Rinpoche, Sarame in Balukubi, I think the second one, Ken Nyiba, right? The ceramic lama, the longevity. Ah, give me a second camp, a small monastery, the old lama. They're like pure old lama. His own son was highly precious. He's a Gautama Geshe Potowa. He always highly precious. Rinpoche, Gautama Geshe Potowa. All lamas were so kind of pure, really good example. So in the house, there are spiders. Spiders, they put office, they made their office, website. They made their office in the corner of the house. Spiders, they made their office. So, and his manager comes to clean up but the Rinpoche never want to disturb the spiders in the room, in the corner of the room. Like that. So imagine that. So anyway, I went to get all transmission of the advices, to get some Dhamma connection, but Rinpoche could not see the small letters. So I didn't get a big text. So I didn't get teachings from Rinpoche, didn't happen. So I asked Rinpoche, where she is, Zina. So Rinpoche did observation. She said, best. So masters will be something, them is something as a deputy treaty, we said, in the Bajogan Pure Land. So if you're born there, definitely you're going enlightened. Amitabha realm, only free from Lojong, but you don't become enlightened there. Because it will enlighten you by Tantra. So there's no Tantra teaching truth there. So then I have a pen friend, 90 years old, 80, 90, member of London Buddhist Society. So she looked after me for 7 years or something. So school, when I was school, and at TV, so all the medicine, milk, and all the things. I found out much later, she spent money to one of our school, Baksa, that, and sent one set of robe to me. She asked one nun, first British nun ordained by Tromagishi, which not the past your grave, but the next one, who were born in Sikkim, and they went to Tibet to become Geshe. So he ordained. This among the Western people, the first nun, among the Western people, first British nun, Sister Bajra. So Rinpoche ordained. It's a kind of an impossible thing, but it happened. So she sent, the Rachel Levy sent to her, and she made a set of robe to the Game of Boxer when I was. So this is what I dressed. What I dress Tibetan New Year's. what a dress is that one. So anyway, then ask Rinpoche, Tarim, 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 I think. So I asked about, what about that, she died. So I asked about that. And Rinpoche said, Jimo, the version. Then he said, she's good now. Only now. Now it's good. That's what Rinpoche said. They didn't say very good. You like the first one. many monks and Sarah. Extremely learned ones, and many not learned, but very good, a good life. Not learned, but good devotion to the guru, and lived a good life, I guess. You know, sincere life, truthful life. So those practice Sudha Tantra, so anyway, even though they're not learned, they're not known especially in one sense. So many of them passed during death, many death, due to the incarnate death. So one Pema Janzen, one monk, Bambaksa, our house, but he's a little bit is outside in the Pemba house. Simple monk, day and night memorize text and thing. Simple monk. So anyway, it's become very learned. Baksa in the house. So he passed away. He passed away. He was a meditation collector for a long time. 18 days or 21 something, 28 or 24, I'm not sure, but many days he was in meditation, longest time. Many other monks who were not put him, not landed. So many others passed away. Great surprise. In meditation. 7 days and 5 days and those are going to come. Meditation. So they get born pure land or different levels. So that's many. In the Kasa, Tawa comes in, the same comes in, the Geshini Tawa comes in. There's one monk, he's not particularly learned, not learned. Somebody will teach philosophy to it, it's not like that. I'm not sure. But he's very sincere. Very sincere. He goes puja. Because of the Jigiva Shabden Dava Drawani Arato Sevji. Because of the Sawa Kamse. Jigirin is in Yoda. The Sandai Jigsumi Taji Machawa Tenji. I mean, Shidugara Kasa Taji Machawa Tenji. Shidugara Mega Tudun Shursa. Kokasa Ta. Ming Tingde. So there was a one monk, understanding the philosophy, very sincere. So after you through the great initiation, the highest tantra, Kuya Samacha, Yamantaka, Chara Sambara, deities, then you see, you receive from Lama, because Guru, then you recite the Satana every day without breaking, without missing. So every day. Every day he decides without missing. So that is all. Very sincere. Right? Then he does three satana commitment, you see. So then when he passed away, he was meditation. Yeah, very special. There are many ordinary monks like that who don't know, who don't have particular, normally not known, special, not dharma, not learning. Then the Dhamma or not like that, just ordinary. Then when they pass away, great. Then everybody rejoice. You know, in meditation, so everybody rejoice at the dead time. So there's one monk who was angry, He's famous in angry. Everybody knows, very famous in angry. One monk, I don't name, but one very angry, very famous in the one monastery. When he died, he was in meditation. I don't know how many days he was able to be in meditation. So I don't know that monk. Sometimes they can be, you know, holy beings. Outside appears like that, but inside a great realized being. I mean Buddha Sabha can be any holy being. Sometimes outside ordinary, what we see, what the person is, something what the person is way beyond. What we see, our ordinary view, it's very ordinary, something, you know, our view, our ordinary mind view, or something like that. Sometimes like that, woman, man, sometimes like that. Not what you see. The reality of the person beyond. There are many like that. So what we see is just very ordinary. You may think, oh, this person, you think this person man or dharma? No thing like that. There's also like that. What you see, you think it's a very, very ordinary being. You know, sometimes the action is like, like this person, mango, you know, something contradictory to something looking like that, but the reality person is way beyond, not ordinary being. That's like that. So anyway, there are many monks who, ordinary monks, pass away, meditation, those. So those are the, so I tell one story. One monk, from Baksa, old monk, Tiyukamba, one old monk. He always comes to puja in chura, you know, debating place, whether to pray and debating, class by class, and one by one, in the short color. So in the night time, 12, someone's still there, 12:31. So the old monk, you know, big, big one with this, he carry, then he comes to puja all the time. He saw devotee Sukuru. Gunyibu, Kinyibu, Nido, Kinyido. I don't know his name probably. I used that before. Kinyibu, Nido, Yina Nido, Nibu, so always. So sensei. So devotee Sukuru. So sensei. Doesn't know the philosophy or divinity. Can't put that, then say something about it. So he was South India, moved from Baksa, the monks. Also was 1,500 monks who couldn't even study. But many monks left for big fixing road, the army, you know, India army, near Tibet or something like that. So Geshe Ujjain Chitin, his guru is Geshe Ujjain Chitin, very famous teacher. So in Sarache, our college, that's one lineage, Geshe Ujjain Chitin. Then many great teachers. Then the Geshe Doga, Geshe Sunarinjin, many others. So one lineage. Then there's Geshe Losang, which was top lineage. When they said Tibet, top lineage. So there's a lineage. Then there's Geshe Rabdin, my teacher, who taught me beginning philosophy. Geshe Rabdin, great mentor, great philosophy scholar. So there's a lineage. So Geshe Rabdin, then he went to Geshe Nido, Geshe Nigu. Now, because he went to see Geshe Ujjain, his teacher. So, lineage. So, I want to rebate again. 3 years to see, I want to get permission. So, again, his teacher said, "Oh, do you know, if you don't do 3 years rebate again, do you know what are the three aspects of pastoring that one? Do you know?" So, I think his teacher knows that Geshe Nyinga doesn't know about the essence of Dharma, the renunciation of bodhicitta, right view, three principal aspects of the path to enlightenment. His teacher knows, he can tell. So, do you know about this? How can you do 3 years retreat? You do know this, essence of Dharma. So he can't tell. He didn't remember, he can't tell to his teacher. So then, this you can't tell, how you going to tell what you're going to say? So then, however, he did tell what you're going to say. And when he passed away, he was meditation. Even he can't tell what are the three pairs of path, he can't tell. Renunciation, Bodhisattva, he can't tell. Can't inform to his teacher. But he did see about him. He was mentioned. He's so pure and so sincere, so devoted to the Guru. But not learning philosophy. So very good human being. Monk, very good monk. Very good hearted. Much devoted to the Guru. So that's all. So death sad, colored, but mounted. Then you see, going to Pure Land Chota. Well, law realm is impossible. I mean, you know, something. So many happened. Even though I think the caretaker of the Gomba, not before, there was one monk taking care of Gomba, and he died. And she was meditation. It's a very good monk. It's a very good monk. So many of the monks, I think, they have a good version, good connection with the good samaya. Then I think sincere. So not many of them don't have the reputation of learning. No. It's a very common. No other monks regard to common mongrel. It's ordinary. But when they pass away, great example, meditation. One monk, I know, one monk, when Lava comes in, so there's a group, some different groups of monks. So one monk, when he going to pass away, he dressed up. He robes, it was new, dressed up. He paid all the money. He owed different people, he paid everything. He dressed up new clothes, new. Then he went round the whole Sarah. He went round Sarah, walked around Sarah, telling everyone goodbye. Telling every other ones goodbye. Then he came back in the room, and he passed away in meditation. Then another monk, there's another monk, another old monk. I forgot now. Took care my teacher Geshe Rabden, great scholar and mentor in Tibet. So the Kansha Gege, I think the Lama, we have checked the Lama. So Genkajin, his name is Genkajin. So old monk. So he's very good heart, devotion to the Guru, very good heart. Old one does not debate all this, you know. It does debate when there's a Geshe examination or something, but not particularly. Very good heart. And very sincere, very good heart. The prayers. So he went for a walk, came back. Then a bowl is filled with Tibetan tea. Tibetan tea, you know, good Tibetan tea. Bowl in power. Then he was meditation, he passed away, meditation, kill that. Genkajin, so all around. So amazing. So, all that. So I think maybe I just touch. I was able to just touch. So, yeah. Chancho Sencho Rinpo Jema Jeva Na Jeju Jeva Nyamba Meva Yeku Ne Kundu Pewa Raju Tunyi Dawa Rinpo Jema Jeva Na Jeju Jeva Nyamba Meva Yeku Kundu Pewa Raju Kandira Pekuru Ejit Pendan Dewa Malu Jine Jere Sewa Tintin Jasu Chave Sete Bato Tini Tony Ni Je Sundu Jive Cheche Sanje Kanjen Tendroga Changna Pemo Tintin Jasu La Sawa Ante To Shende Nandro Jho Jiju Oda Three Time Mere Tukrashi Bami Three Time Mere Tukrashi Bami Namba Listen to me. And then three times it's called the number of Buddhas. That which do not exist from its own side. Totally empty from its own side. Is that the Buddhas who do not exist from its own side? Who is totally empty from its own side? Achieve the full enlightenment, which do not exist from its own side. Totally, which is totally empty from its own side. And lead all the sentient beings who do not exist from its own side. Totally empty from its own side. To that full enlightenment which do not exist from its own side. By myself alone, who do not exist from his own side. It's entirely empty from his own side. Jambalamba vichitra jimba ta kunta sangpa deyan de jin de de ta kunti je tun tal gawa de ta tam je ratu ngu otu dun je pi java tam je jing ngu akang la chu tu ngu va yin ta ya ke ve ta va de Kunya sangpo che che ratu ngu ala inji. Adin mita la dhiro ta tri tai me li tukra tri me kura tri me nama li sin tri nama li tukra tri. Adin ka su re. Stainless steel lama tsungapa. Be spread, means actualized in your mind. And you spread and actualize in the heart walls and freedom oceans or something like that, achieve enlightenment and that, content that.
Chuji jabo tsonga ve chutu namba pe vata keje tsama shiva ta tunje malu ya tsama iju Dada Shinji Tuzundan Tewe Tsunye La Tene Jawa Lo San Tawa Tenpa Yurin Banjo Ju.
In Lugu, the monk who can explain to his guru what are the essence of Buddhism, the three things apart. And the answer is again Lugu. Thank you, Lugu. So thank you very much. Yeah, thank you.